imagine you're whispering a secret in a crowded room, and despite the noise, you have this unsettling feeling that someone is listening in, catching every word. Well, this is kind of like our lives today, where our private conversations, midnight shopping sprees, and your digital footprint may be on display. Now, with the concern around privacy, we often hear these three letters. VPN. Use a VPN. Well, let's talk about a VPN. To expand, this is a virtual private network. Now, imagine a VPN like a secret path you can take on the internet that helps you to keep your online steps more private. But here's the thing, a VPN isn't always a magic shield that makes you completely invincible. It's more like a special tool that makes it harder for others to watch what you're doing. But how does it work? Do you really need one? And how do you know which one to choose? All right, we are going to be exploring all of that today. We're going to break down how VPNs work, when they can really help, and when they might not be the answer to everything. So if you're curious about making your online time a bit more private, or you just want to understand what all this VPN talk is about, then you're definitely in the right place. Now, before we get into it, let's talk about the sponsor of today's video, which is IPVanish. IPVanish offers a blend of speed, security, and simplicity. But what makes IPVanish the VPN of choice for so many? Well, IPVanish has an independently verified no logs policy. So this means that they do not keep track of where you go or what you do online when you're connected to their service. And this also means that they would have no information to give about your digital whereabouts, because they literally keep no record. And then there is the matter of accessibility. So with IPVanish, you can connect to a vast network of servers spread across the globe, whether you're looking to access content from back home while traveling or exploring your favorite streaming services, IPVanish makes it possible with only a few clicks. Security is another cornerstone of the IPVanish service. They use strong encryption to protect your data as it travels through their tunnels, offering advanced protection. And for those concerned about speed, IPVanish's service is designed to provide fast connection speeds, making it ideal for streaming, gaming, and downloading large files without the frustrating lag or buffering. Now, choosing the right package also makes a huge difference. So IPVanish offers various plans to fit your needs and your budget. All their plans include an unlimited number of devices. So this flexibility ensures that whether you're a solo internet explorer or looking to protect a whole family of devices, there is a plan that fits. Remember, online safety is holistic. So while IPVanish offers tools for enhancing your online privacy, it's part of a broader strategy. Using strong passwords, being mindful of the information you share online, and keeping your devices updated are all really important steps in safeguarding your digital life. Now, grab your coffee. Let's talk a little bit about why I started using VPNs. So, here's the deal. A while back, I found myself super into exploring different cultures, right? And a huge part of that was diving into content from all over the world. But I literally got limited by my location all the time. Some things were just simply not available in the country where I live, which was a major bummer. One day, I was trying to watch this documentary series from my bestie, which is halfway across the world, and of course I was blocked again. So enter the VPN, which sounded techy, but it really is not. The idea was pretty straightforward. A VPN helped me to cross those digital boundaries and access content from anywhere, which was just the start of my VPN use cases. But as I started learning more about the VPN technology and the purpose and the use of a VPN service, something hit me, right? So it hit me just how much of my online activity, like what sites I visit or what I stream, could be watched by others, including the company that gets me online, my ISP, internet service provider. So then it begs the question, what else do they know about what I'm doing online? So I really needed to up my privacy, to keep my online activities just for me, not my ISP, or really anyone else who might be snooping.
The reality is that I do not want ISPs to be selling my information without me knowing. I do not want them collecting my credit card data, and I certainly don't want my information used to allow companies to sell me products.
And that's really how I started using VPNs, or virtual private networks. So using a VPN meant that I could access my content, browse my favorite sites, and not worry about unwanted internet snoopers, at least while I'm connected to my VPN. So incorporating a VPN into my daily toolset became about taking back a piece of my privacy in this huge online world. But let's think back a little bit on the original purpose of the VPN. So think back to a time when businesses started expanding with offices in different countries or different cities. They faced a big challenge. How do you send information back and forth securely? And that's where VPNs came in. They created safe paths or tunnels through the internet so businesses could send their data securely from one place to another without worrying about getting intercepted. It was like having a private hidden bridge that only they could use. How does a VPN actually work? Now, let's get into it. So imagine you're online, browsing websites, streaming videos, or chatting with friends. Typically, everything you do online goes straight from your device to your internet service provider, your ISP, and from there to the wider internet. This direct route allows your ISP to see your online destinations and activities because each piece of data that you send or receive carries your unique digital address, similar to your home address that identifies your physical location. Now, a VPN changes this direct route. So when you use a VPN, it first encrypts your data. This means that it converts your information into a secure code that can only be deciphered by your device and the VPN server. This process effectively scrambles your data, making it unreadable to anyone who might intercept it, like cyber criminals or your ISP. Next, the VPN does something clever with your IP address, which is the part of your data that tells the internet where to send information back to you. So the VPN replaces your personal IP address with one of its own. Because VPN services are located all over the world, it can make it appear as though you're accessing the internet from a completely different location. This not only helps with privacy, but it can allow you to access content that's restricted in your actual location. And to go a step further, a reliable VPN service commits to a no-logs policy. This means the VPN itself doesn't keep any records of your internet activity. So even if someone were to inquire about your online activities, the VPN would have no data to share. This policy is really important for ensuring that your online actions actually remain private and confidential. All right, now there are many reasons for why you should be using a VPN service and a few components you should consider when selecting your VPN service provider. Firstly, is the privacy from ISPs, from your internet service provider. So this is required in order to hide your IP address from internet service providers and prevent them from monitoring your activities or sending warnings or anything based on your usage. Then, security on public Wi-Fi. For added security, when connecting to unsecured or sketchy public Wi-Fi networks, a proper VPN service will help to protect your data from any potential eavesdroppers while you're connected to that Wi-Fi network. Then we also want sufficient protection from malicious websites. So Some VPN services offer features that protect your devices from being infected with malware by blocking access to these malicious websites and malicious domains. And really importantly, for keeping your online activities private. So VPNs can keep your browsing, streaming, emailing, and downloading activities private. So protecting your identity and your data from being collected by unwanted third parties. Then we also want the ability to have device protection to protect all our devices with either just one click or really simple configuration. So a VPN service helps to offer simple and secure solutions for multiple devices without requiring kind of individualized configuration. When you're on the lookout for VPN, don't just jump at the first one you see. Really, do your homework. Look for a VPN that is upfront about its policies, one that promises to deliver no logs. A no logs policy is super important. And one that provides strong encryption to keep your data secure.
That's why I am so happy to have partnered with IPVanish for this video. They have checked off all the boxes for what is considered a good VPN service.
All right. We have talked a lot about VPNs today. Remember, knowledge is power, especially when it comes to protecting your online privacy. So, with the insights that you gained in this video and tools like IPVanish, you're better equipped to really face these digital streets more securely. Remember to check out IPVanish. All of the details are in the description box below. That is it for this video. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.